next to me. Then I remember, maybe it's not all that it seems. Forget reality, cause mixed up when it's me. Since you found the truth,
you have amongst the void,
and it's you that breaks me apart when we cry. Every night when I'm going to sleep, are we dreaming? But now your things around the place. Then I remember all the things we used to do. Seems that I have my nothing when my everything is you. We found the truth.
You are amongst the lies,
and it's you that breaks me apart when we cry. Every
counting days since my love up and got lost on me. And every breath that I've been taking since you left feels like a waste on me. I've been holding on to hope that you'll come back when you can find some peace. Cause every word that I've heard spoken since you left feels like a hollow street. I've been told to get you off my mind, but I hope I never lose the bruises that you left behind. Oh my Lord, I need you by my side. There must be something in the water, cause every day it's getting colder. And if only I could hold you, you'd keep my head from going under. Maybe I'm just being blinded by the brighter side of what we are, because it's over. Well, there must be something in the tide. I've been told to get you off my mind, but I hope I never lose the bruises that you left behind. Oh my Lord, I need you by my side.
Hiya, coming in. My mum doesn't know you're here. Careful, yeah. Got for the boys for the party. Can you pass one? Yeah. Looks great.
It was a cold, dark night. Charlotte had friends over while on FaceTime with Millie.
Hi.
Hi. Are you almost ready?
Yeah, I am. Are you?
Almost, not quite.
All right.
Do you fancy going trick-or-treating?
Trick-or-treating? You're joking. We're 18, not 5.
Come on, it'll be fun. Please?
Oh, fine.
Also, have you heard the news?
No. Why? What's happened?
There's a killer escaped from prison and he's supposed to be really dangerous and, well, he goes by the name of the Candyman.
The Candyman? The Candyman? You're joking. We're meant to be scared of him and he's got a name like the Candyman.
I'm being serious. He kills girls our age.
Are you sure you want to go out?
The news says he's in Leeds and, well, we're in Horden, so it'll be a trek for him to get here, so we should be fine.
All right, you scared me for a second.
Charlotte still has friends over, but she hears footsteps coming up.
Shh, go on, my mum doesn't know you're here. Come in.
Hi.
Hi.
What's all this noise? I heard you over the TV downstairs.
I was just talking to Millie on the phone.
With all this mess?
Yeah, I was just, you know, playing with feather balls by myself, as you do.
Well, you better get it cleaned up before you go out.
All right, I will do. Sorry, ma'am.
Bye.
Bye. So, where are we meeting and when?
Let's say 6:30.
All right, that works.
Actually, why don't you just come over when you're ready?
Okay, that's all right.
Yeah?
All right, bye.
Okay, bye, lovely.
Bye.
Millie gets a text alert about the Candyman.
The Candyman? He's armed and dangerous, so please be cautious while out tonight.
I'm here.
Come right up.
Hiya.
Hi, I'm not quite ready yet, but...
Oh, that's all right.
I'm so sorry about the mess. I was supposed to clean up before you came, but...
Oh, that's all right. Got a new decoration?
Yeah, Mum made it. It's supposed to be a spider.
That looks nothing like a spider.
You're telling me, but, you know.
At least you tried.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just going to keep it up for the rest of the week.
Okay.
Oh, did you get the text from the news?
No. Why? What's happened?
About the Candyman?
Oh, it's fine. What is it? Something changed?
They've said he's armed now and we're supposed to be cautious tonight and... I'm just worried.
But if he's in Leeds, then surely we'll be fine. That's at least 2 hours away.
Yeah, but he could come at any second. Charlotte, I'm scared.
Not really. It's fine. He's in Leeds. We'll be completely fine. We'll have fun at the party and you'll forget about it there.
Do you think so?
Yeah.
I hope so. Do you think there'll be many there?
Probably. Who's throwing it again?
Isn't it James?
Yeah, I think so.
Have you seen my other shoe?
No.
Because I haven't seen it all night.
While Millie is looking for her shoe, Charlotte then notices shadows outside the door.
I thought you said we were home alone.
We are. What you talking about?
I'll just go to the toilet, do you mind?
No problem.
All right, see ya.
Oh, found the shoe.
Speak to me. and what I am. We never told the truth for 10 minutes in this house. Well, hear this, Dad. This is me. You want to know why I didn't have an address for 3 months last year? Because I stole a suit in London and was in jail. In fact, I stole myself out of every good job since high school and never got anywhere because you blew me so full of hot air, I can never stand taking orders from anyone else. That's whose fault it is. It's goddamn time you heard that, Dad. You know, I ran down 11 flights with a pen in my hand today. Suddenly I stopped. Do you hear me? I stopped in the middle of the office building. Do you hear this? I stopped in the middle of the building and I saw the sky. In fact, I saw all the things I love in this world. The food, the work, the time to just sit and smoke. I looked at the pen and thought, what am I grabbing this for, huh? Why am I trying to become something I don't want to be? What am I doing in an office, making a contemptuous, begging fool of myself, when everything I want is out there, waiting for me, the second I say I know who I am? Why can't I say that, Dad? Dad, look at me. I'm a dime a dozen, Dad. And so are you. I'm not a leader of men. And neither are you. You were never anything but a hard-working drummer who landed in the ash can like the rest of them. And as for me, I'm a pound an hour, Dad. I tried 7 cities, I couldn't raise it. £1 an hour. I'm not bringing home prizes anymore. You've got to stop waiting for me to bring them home, Dad. I'm nothing. I'm just what I am. That's all.
Does it matter to you that I'm going mad? Not sure I can go away and reflect on it. Not sure I can get through my own madness. If I go to the top of a mountain like a Buddhist monk, perhaps I may have a chance. Life, my DNA, it's all fit perfectly together, hasn't it? What is it for? For my art? Is it fair for a man to sacrifice his sanity for his craft? Is that what God wants? If that is so, then why must I be sacrificed? Why does great beauty come from great pain? We're all mad, crazy nuts, psychos, it's true. Walk down the street and look into the eyes of the man or woman you walk past. It's hidden. It's hidden. When you're someone like me, You connect with that dark place instantly. And you identify with it. I forget who said, we're all living lives of quiet desperation. I believe we are. The smiles, the charms, it's all bullshit. All smokescreen. We all suffer within, don't we? Sometimes, I will stare into the mirror and wait for the madness to creep from my eye and leave me once and for all. But all it ever does is reach the surface and smile gently at me with a wise gleam. Yeah, I am crazy. I love that I'm crazy, but I also hate who I am. I wouldn't expect you to understand that. They say genius and madness have a fine line between them. I walk that fence every day, and lately, it's been getting harder to stay balanced. Hell, look where I am. Chemical imbalance, sure. Life experience, sure. Being an artist, sure. It all adds up to a pair of scissors embedded in someone's neck. Doesn't it? You can ridicule me more, my friend. You can pity me. You can lead me to inspiring advice. But the truth is, there is nothing you can do or say that can haunt me more than my own damn soul. So do what you have to do. Say what you have to say. Because it means nothing. Nothing, my friend. Nothing. I will be waiting for you. I will be waiting. I'm happy to entertain you, my friend. I look forward to your next word. You can speak now. Say something!
Ever felt like you're not good enough, and no matter what you do, you'll never ever make them proud?
You've got the words to change a nation, but you're biting your tongue. You've spent a lifetime stuck in silence, afraid you'll say something wrong. If no one ever hears
you fight,
how we're gonna learn your song?
So but your hands are just,
come on,
they're not strong
come
enough.
Come on, you've got a heart as loud as lion. So why let your voice be tamed? Maybe we're a little different. There's no need to be ashamed.
It's,
you've got the light.
It's
to
like you're fighting.
Shadow, so stop hiding.
It's like you're drowning. You just can't catch your breath.
Let's get the
you see her there, but just a body. Our soul's gone and you start to scream and scream and you scream until you've got no air left in your lungs. You scream.
Read all about it.
So you try again. Paul, come. Mam's not breathing. Mam's not breathing. And you're running and you're running. And you're trying to push the life back in, but nothing's working. So you just lie there. You lie.
So fearful. Now we're finally finding our voices. So take a chance, come help me sing.
But you look at the sky.
Yeah, we're all wonderful, wonderful.
And you're trying not to cry.
So when
but
we
you just
so
you smile because it's your mom. She wouldn't want you to carry on.
Voices. Just take a chance, come help me.
Until I've got no air left in my lungs. She was my mom, and she would have wanted us to be happy. But I still scream, and I scream, and I scream, and I scream. She's here in my head and in my heart, but I just wish she was here. So I smile, and I smile, and leave out the rest.
Morning, I'm Caitlin and I'm part of Student Union. We're looking for new members to join. Do you fancy it? Okay, no bother. Have a good day. Oh, hiya there. You see, we're advertising for a new president for Student Union. Would you like to come along? That's all right. Hello. You see, we're looking for new members and it's full of amazing opportunities and it'd look great on your CV. It's a chance for your voice to be heard. You know, I want to be famous. Not like a famous singer or actress. I want to be known for helping people. I only want the fame to come because I know it'll make people more aware of my cause. I plan on using fame to strengthen what I believe in, for the benefit of others. I see so many horrible things going on in the world. So many people suffering in so many different countries, including our own. It makes me think, what kind of future is my generation gonna have? This is what motivates me, helping people. That much I'm certain of. I know there's nothing else I wish to do with my life than make this world better, bring people together and make things good. I'm taking time now, while I'm young, to figure out a plan and strategies to make a difference. I'm not trying to claim that I want to be some sort of saint, but I know my calling is to bring about change here before I leave, and I know I will.
I can't believe him. Stick my neck out for him and he does this to us. 4 years we've known each other. 4 years. Oh, can I copy homework down? No, you can't. Is what I want to say. But of course, every time that's come out as, yeah, no bother, that's just fine. And then when I've been caught for cheating, he's got the audacity to sit there quietly and let me take all the blame. He's happy for me to get a 30-minute lecture for something that wasn't even my bloody fault. He's never doing this to us again. He's never doing this to me again. I'm sick of it. Prick. And I'm done.
You want to know why I come to this art gallery? I come here to think. I look at this tree each time, and it's not by a famous photographer, but I like it because it reminds me of myself. It's so broken and bruised. I don't know how many times it's been battered around in the wind and the rain. I'm surprised it hasn't fallen over. Life, battered, bruised, knocked down. When's the next storm coming?
It's finally Christmas! I can't wait to watch a load of Xmas movies and stuff my face full of food till I feel like my stomach's going to explode and do some stargazing tonight. It's going to be so much fun. Getting on the roof's going to be a bit of a pain, but it's definitely worth it. I have to do the boring part though, don't I? I have to drag myself up that bloody snowy hill over that pesky bit of fence. I always rip my jeans on them. But I guess I get to see her again, so it's definitely worth it. Oh, I can't contain my excitement. But I can't get caught. I can't get caught. I just can't. I mean, I could be killed for getting caught. Or worse. Oh, God. What am I worrying myself about? What am I worrying myself about? Nothing's gone wrong. I've done this for years. Nothing bad's going to happen. Is it?
Dangerous ways, searching for a distant place, not too far from home, and it's all too much when you can't see the shiny under the rise, so you hide away, shelter from the rain, and I've been getting tired of all these letters I see you written on the walls. And I've been walking through my own disasters, thinking it's time to move on. I don't wanna run from a bully, gotta leave my candle light burning. If it goes out, I will lose it. Candlelight burn, burn, burn. I feel something pulling. Gotta leave my candlelight burning. If it goes out, I will lose it. Gotta let my candlelight burn, 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 burn. Here I lay in my bed, everything I hate, dreaming of a distant place, though a heavy light. You love and you cry. Do you give up or do you try? Why live a lie, live a lie? Who am I? Who am I? I don't wanna run from a bully. Gotta leave my candlelight burning. If it goes out, I will lose it. Gotta let my candlelight burn, burn, burn. I feel something pulling. Gotta leave my candlelight burning. If it goes out, I will lose it. Candlelight burn, 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 burn.
Do you know my little sister, India? Of course you don't. We just met. Well, anyway, let me tell you this story. Earlier, I was getting ready for the party, and my little sister said to me, "Will you do me makeup?" Me? Well, would I want to do wear makeup for? But anyway, I'm a great sister. So I did it. And then my mother had the audacity. Tell me I had to take her trick-or-treating. No. Guess what? I did. And then, never guess what happened. There was no sweets. Anyway, we went all across town and there was none. So I said, I'll take you home and we'll get sweets next year. No, I want to take sweets to the houses. That's not what Halloween is. Yet again, I went with Dad to the shop and bought sweets with my alcohol money. But my mother is going to be furious. I don't want to go home. But lucky for me, I went to that party and I got drunk. I might be lost and I might be a little late, but it's all my fault. It's all my fault.
I'm alone, alone, alone. Of every second, of every minute, of every hour, my stomach is empty, yet my mind is full, overwhelmed. I can hear your voice surrounding me like a dark shadow cast over me, breaking me down piece by piece. Yet again, I'm alone, 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 crying at night, crying in the mirror, crying, wishing you were here beside me. Why did you leave? Why did you make promises that you knew you were going to break? What was the point in even trying when we both knew what God wasn't going to last? I'm submerged underneath your memories and knowing that you're in somebody else's arms. Well, it's killing me inside. I've become friends with the demons in my own mind because there's no one else. No one can save me this time. Not you, not him, no one. I'm forever alone, alone, alone.
Should grow up someday, 'cause I got bills to pay. I can't be waking up at someone else's place. I know I drink too much, can't pay my rent this month. I should be saving up, but I just got